afflicted, the injured, the crippled, those wretches no longer able to fend for their own well-being. The seasoned feeble masses who put their trust in the halls of science, who have sown their faith in the world of medicine. We surgeons have seen fit to devote our lives to these sad kids. These people whose time has come. We delay the inevitable, attempting to give mankind the strength to withstand death, to live but for a few days more. I say no more. I say tally no longer on the frail and infirm. I say, give no more peace to the withered and old. I say, the greatest sickness of all is named man, and it needs to be excised from the earth like a boil. I say, kill them all.
Yeah. scientist.
You are a doctor, and the project stands saving lives, not taking it.
Yeah.
with the skull cap removed, I have placed the needles and tubing directly into the adrenal glands located at the brain's posterior.
Thank you, Dr. Sewage. And as you can all see, according to the EEG monitor, our patient has arrived at a state of consciousness. He should, with perfect clarity of sense, soon become aware of his situation. His brain waves will begin to peak as he comes to understand what it means to be a volunteer here at St. Julian's. Now, Dr. Varela will explain the reagent we've developed.
Gracias, Dr. McGrath. What is amazing about our new reagent is not how it works, but how it does not. You see, we found the chemicals which will halt the patient's locomotor functions, but not the pain receptors or nerves. Now, in order to save the patient's glands and blood generation as much as possible, I will amputate his limbs, which you will see he feels completely. If you monitor the increased heart rate on the EKGs. Dr. LaBarre will explain the gland collection while I continue the operation.
Through the tubing inserted into the patient's exposed cranium, we can retrieve the prodigious amounts of adrenal and pituitary secretions, while the heart valve suctions out regular portions of plasma, leaving the patient with a minimum number of pints on which to live. What we found is that the psychological shock and physical pain incurred to the patient while awakening to such rigors under the influence of a reagent becomes permanent, resulting in an excess production of the precious glandular fluid and superoxygenated blood.
Thank you, Dr. LaBarre. So the end result is an organic factory, capable of sustaining production for up to 6 months, until the patient's body withers from cellular hyperactivity or he suffers brain death from the induced psychological trauma.